was introduced back into the country. Now, maybe not from British shores, but certainly from this end of England. Introduced back into the country, particularly in Chilterns. Here is the mild Whitney Street. Tell you that I, until this week, had never heard of the Miles Whitney Strait. I don't these days very often come across an aeroplane I haven't heard of, so it's very nice to see this beautiful little aeroplane. Sounds like something out of Agatha Christie's Miles Whitney Strait. Designed by F.G. Miles of Miles Aircraft, the first half of the 1930s, with the help of Whitney Strait, who actually was a well-off Anglo-American Grand Prix racing driver, very smooth operator. Get a good look at the jet cockpit flying from the left-hand seat of the two-seat aircraft. Side-by-side seating. Whitney Strait said he wanted comfortable accommodation for pilot, passenger, and of course the necessary luggage. He wanted it to be in an enclosed side-by-side compartment. So this is the result. As you can see, fixed undercarriage, spatted wheels, paper, streamlined, drag as possible. It's mainly made of wood, this aeroplane. Spruce frames and three-ply birch coverings. No fabric coverings for this.
Which is great. What can be done? Plywood coverings. What's the altitude?
FG Miles, the head man of Miles Aircraft, himself. Successful little aeroplane, 50 or more workouts in the next year, but after that, they stopped. When the war came along, the Air Ministry impressed 23 of them. That's to say, they took them over, took them into military service as comms aircraft. This very aeroplane, I have to tell you, was the aircraft on the stationed flight here at Abingdon during the war. This aeroplane was based here, the station flight. That was the formal name they gave to the aircraft that was available on the station for pilots to use for communications purposes. That's what they used to call that. Usually meant if you were lucky you could borrow it to go away for the weekend. So this aeroplane is really an Abingdon aeroplane. Whitney Street station flight at Royal Air Force Abingdon. This is the only Miles Whitney Strait left flying in the world. It had been bought from new in 1937 by Mr. W.H. Moore, and after the war, well actually in 1947, the Air Ministry returned it to him, still in good nick. He flew it until 1962. So he had it for 25 years then. It went through various owners until eventually it was
cleared. Right, so give me 1 minute to finish.
Where is it? Rotted away, so to say. But in 2005, one CD rescued it from derelict. And they completely rebuilt this area. Restorer Ron Souch at Aero Antiques. Painstakingly recreated, using most of the original metal, but mostly new wood. Not only the plywood skinning, but also with perfect new spars, new ribs, and new longerons, those are the things that run up and down the fuselage. Got a few modern items, as well as a self-starter, which they used not to have, disc brakes. This restoration took 3 years and 5,000 pounds. How worthwhile it has been when you see this lovely little aeroplane purring by. That sound, by the way, comes from the Gypsy Major air-cooled four-cylinder inline engine. Absolutely the classic sound of 1930s and 1940s private flying. It's a sound of my childhood. I remember being in my grandfather's garden listening to the airplanes flying in white weather. It was a summer sun. Something about that sound, it has no irritation to it. Jez Cook's the man displaying it. It's funny, we had Jez Charlton earlier flying the helicopter. He's Jez, which is short for Gerald. This Jez is short for Jeremy. There we go. He's been displaying as Jez Cook for more than 25 years, learned to fly at the age of 14. More than 12,000 hours. He's a test pilot for the Civil Aviation Authority. And his day job is flying long-range business jets. He's continually owned their events.
Right, we are running very early, so terminate when you're ready.
The age of 20.
I tried to do a couple more and finished it up.
He was actually a member of the Crunchy Flying Circus, which all wing wingers.
I'm done. Right. Starting now, isn't it?
An earlier version of the.
Don't worry.
The wing wingers team. For a fidget Mustang racer aircraft base that fidget. What a wonderful name for an airfield. Oh, sorry, it should be an aerodrome, really, shouldn't it? Incident hedges. It's better than much binding in the marsh, really, which actually was originally thought to be moving in marsh. Mind you, if you're younger than me, and probably quite a lot of people here are, I don't know what much finding in the marsh was, but it was a wonderful home service radio program. Richard Murdoch and Kenneth Hall, as I recall. Well, I think Jez Cook was actually going to finish his display, but they asked him to carry on a little longer. We don't mind about that, because we're going to have a little bit of a break after this. Unless they decide to rejig the program, because the next aircraft we're going to see is a Spitfire, and that's coming from Coningsby, the home of the Battle of Britain.
I think we're not big forward by now.
He thinks we're big forward by now.
Okay, I'll do my pass and then do a thumbs up alone, thanks.
And it's a reminder of perhaps more gracious days. So, expect the Spitfire for the Battle of Britain Memorial flight on the island. I think that little wing down pass is probably Jez's final
flight.
Whitney, sorry, Roger. The surface wind is 0208.
Thank you.
Right to land, as he says.